So today we discuss about the Power BI. In the Power BI, we discuss how can connect your data. The last class, I give you the some example of the connecting the data, how can connect the data. Today, I have discussed the, in detail how can get the data from different applications. So we start from the Excel, right? So we have one data, just like data P, connect here. I have also created the different type of the data. When the creating the data, remember, your data have a first column of your data heading. Start from the first column, just like that. Here is one example for the data. So this data you can easily connect with your Power BI, because this is the data, right? But if you have the some headings from top of, just like data summary 2021, like that time have a problem, because your Power BI read the first column as a heading. So if you have the problem, if you have the data of this type, we have a need to two changing. First, you can select the data and convert in the table format. If you data to convert in the table format, then pivot table easily read this table. Okay, I just save the data like BI data. I give the name BI data in the download. So now I have to connect the data. You can also select the sheet and scan the data, right? And now if you have the data not starting from the top of the row, but you have your data convert in the table format, that time you can easily connect the data just like that. BI data, you can see here I have select the table. See here's table. Also sheet one here. Also sheet one here. But also separately read the table. Okay. If you have the data in the table in the not proper format, but you can also convert the data in the table format. That time your data easily read like that. It is clear? Now, if you have the two table, same another data, like we have the C1 also C2. So we have the data in the two tables. And I want to import both our table in the Excel sheet, in the Power BI, sorry. So now we have also used the same procedure. Click here, B data, open. Now here see the table 1 and table 13. You can select here table 1, you can select the only for table 1 and load here, only for table 1 will be included, inserted. If you select the table 13 also, now you can load the two tables, but not a combined, just load here. Load two tables, but you want to combine both of one below one in the below next, just like table 1 below the table 13, like just like collated. So that time use to Power Query in the Power Query. How can you use the Power Query? Okay, I just explained to you. So I want to connect the data with two tables, but above the one table, above the below table. Just like table 13 data below of the table 1 data, right? I don't want to see here the two tables. I want one table, but in the one table have a data collated with two tables. So go to the home tab. Here is the transform. Click on the transform. Open the Power Query editor here. In the Power Query, you can change the different type of the your data. So here is the append query. See here. Hello. So we have create here append query as a new. The first is the table 1 and second is the table 30. But if you are the more than two seats, that time we have used the more than 3 and more than tables here, select here. And you can also select here the position and OK. This is the append one, select here. Now we have renamed. Rename data and now close and apply here. You can see here the new table as a data. So you can insert the multiple files and multiple sheets in the Power BI database. And if you want to customize your data connecting, then use the Power Query. So in future classes, we discuss the Power Query in the details. Okay. Now, if you have data in the Notepad, so how can connect the Notepad? So I have the connect with Notepad, select get data, text and CSV format. And select the your CSV file like data p and notepad file also, then open. See the your data separate directly. There is no choice for the selecting seat, because in the CSV format and in the TST format have only for one data seat. And here is the your separator delimited. If within one column to two column, how can separate? Because comma limited, we have the two type of the CSV and text format. First is the comma limited. Second is the text tab limited. I give you the one example for that. Just I have opened the notepad. I have created the two file. This is the comma limited name, city, and amount. Name is Pooja, city is Delhi, amount is the 500. Name is Om, city is the Pune, amount is the 450. And one again, Uday, city is the Noida. Amount is the 300, right? And save. In the download. Okay. And we have created another notepad file. Here is the template. Name. This is the tab, city, tab, amount. Enter. Pooja, Pune, Om, Noida. Also notepad file. first file is the comma limited. Between one column to another column separated is the comma. And in this file, second number file is the between one column to next another column have a separator separate with the tab. So if you connect thus your CSV file, you connect the one comma separate file. See here is the comma separator comma. By default select, you can change here also. And when you connect with your second file separated by tab, you can see here in the tab. Okay. So before the connecting your notepad and CSV file, first check out what is the separation, tab separate and comma separate. Right, sir? Now we have you want to connect with folder. I have the one folder, and in the folder I have more than 100-250 files I want to connect. You can also select the folder. In the folder, give the path. This PC, not this PC. Right. And okay. The first you can see. Give me the once again. I just check the file list. Not a DD, only for data. Select their folder and connect. And okay. Now you can see here the complete your file list in this folder. Okay. If you just load here, you can get the complete this folder file list in the your Power Query. Not a data. You can see also the apparel.xls, not a data in the apparel.xls. Okay. But you want to combine the all data in the file, in the one sheets. Yeah, right. Yeah. File size. No. There is not file size option. These options, the contain, the binary format, name, extensions, date to access, date to modify, date to created, attribute, and folder path. Okay, but this is not a matter. I want to data. I have the one folder, and the folder have a 12 file for the 2020. I want to complete yearly data. So if you not use this function, then you can manually copy paste. First open the JAN file, copy the data and paste the one combined file. Then second open the FAIR, copy the data and paste in the below of the combined file, one by one. Need to copy paste. Do you understand the problem? But in this Power BI option, we have the combine. You can click the combine and load. When you combine and load, you can get the data of all file. Not a file list, get the data from their file. We have the first file, you can choose the your first file. This is the JAN, the first file, the seat, and OK. You can see here the data too. See here. Name, this is the source, April data, then August data, the property is by all file data will be completed here. Okay, do you understand? So if you have the data in the data separate with the multiple file, and you can combine in the one file, so you can help with the Power BI. Okay, just like we have received the daily basis data file, but I want to create a report the monthly basis. So need to compile the all daily basis data in the one file. That time you can also copy to paste in the one folder the all file, your all day, month file. Just like I can create the January reports. So 31 file in the 31 days in the January. So 31 file copy and paste to one folder, and after that we can copy the folder path and paste in the your data connectivity with folder, and you can get the all data in the one locations completed one by one. Now we have the data in the PDF format. You can also connect with the PDF. Click the file here, select the PDF and connect, and check your PDF data. Right, select here and open. We have the in the PDF have the multiple pages. We have the more than 50 pages in the PDF. So all 50 pages data in the combined in the one database. But in your PDF, in the PDF have a data in the table format, and every table have a heading will be same, right? Like you have received the one PDF file, and in the PDF file have a 10 pages, and several pages have a your data table. So every data table have a heading, the same heading. If you have the same heading, that time your data will be cumulative. Wait a minute, we have the 53 pages, so take your time. In the few minutes, you can see the data. Yeah, right, see here. So we have the 55 pages. There is the 55 pages, you can also insert the one by one over PDF file, but this is not the correct way. But you can see here, 1 to 55 table. In the 1 to 55 table have the correct format, and every pages data here compile here. Okay sir, select and load here. But remember, every PDF pages have a table, and table have a same heading. If a heading is the difference, now here is the different pages, different tables, not a same table. Just like you have the 7 pages and 5 pages in the same heading, and 3 pages have a 2 pages have a different heading. So you can get here the 1 to 5 pages in the cumulative format, and rest of the 2 pages in the different formats. You can understand? Okay. So this is the connectivity with your file.
So today we discussed how can connect with your Excel file in the folder, in the notepad, in the CSV format, also the PDF file. And what is the problem you face when you connect the discuss also what the face problem you have faced when you are connecting your data of this format. So please do the practice on this. Tomorrow we discuss about the how can connect with the databases, just like Access, Oracle, SQL type of databases and online platforms. Okay? Do the practice and meet on the Excel class.